हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग ग्रेट। आई सीए पूजन कपाड़िया वेलकम यू ऑल टू माय टुडेज लेक्चर ऑन द सब्जेक्ट फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट। फ्रेंड्स, इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव कवर्ड विद द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट। टुडे बिफोर स्टार्टिंग विद द न्यू सेशन, आई वुड जस्ट लाइक यू टू रिकॉल ऑल द टॉपिक्स दैट वी हैव कवर्ड इन द लास्ट वीडियो। स्टार्टिंग विद व्हाट वी हैव कवर्ड वाज द मीनिंग ऑफ द टर्म फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट। We have understood that basically financial management was made up of two important words. First is finance, that is related to financial activities, and second relates to management, that we have understood, which includes four important points. It was planning, organizing, directing, and controlling. So basically, at the time of explaining you what is financial management, I have explained that it is nothing. It is the combination of two well-known words that you already know. That is finance plus management. So I can put it in a meaning as planning, organizing, directing, and controlling of financial activities, which can be related to procurement of funds and which can be related to utilization of funds. That is, I explained you, paisa lana kahan se hai aur paisa invest kahan pe karna hai. It is all about financial management. Then we have looked into the definitions of financial management, under which we have studied that first definition is the activity concerned with the planning, raising, controlling, and administering of the funds used in the business. The definition was given by Guthman and Dogel. The second definition read as, it deals with the procurement of funds and their effective utilization in the business. The same definition was given by S.C. Kuchin. So friends, over here, I would just like you to know that there are two definitions that I have provided to you. So if in exam, the question comes, define or write the definition of financial management, you need to write these two definitions. The next point that we have covered in the last slide was nature of financial management. What are the characteristics? What are the basic nature? What are the points that basically defines financial management? So basically there were certain features regarding the financial management which we have covered in the last lecture. It was like universal. That is, it doesn't matter whether your business is small or it is big, whether you're talking about a partnership firm or a company, each and everywhere, there is a need of financial management. Second is, it is a continuous process. It is not like that once you are borrowing the funds from somewhere and once you are investing the fund, your task is over. No, as a financial manager, you need to continuously monitor how the fund is being borrowed. You need to continuously monitor what is the rate of interest. If it is fluctuating, we are going to take an advantage of that opportunity. We need to constantly check that whether the funds are being utilized for the purpose they were borrowed for, etc. So it is not a one-time activity. It is a continuous process. Third is, it has a wider scope. It is not like fund la diya aur usko utilize kar diya. The task is over. Answer is no. It is having a much more wider concept. It starts with how much fund do you require, and it ends with how well you are managing your funds constantly so that not a single opportunity is being missed out. As a result of which, you are focusing on each and every aspect which is related to finance or the funds. Next point is measuring the performance. In this point, we have discussed that basically you need to compare whether the funds, the purpose for which you have borrowed those funds, are being actually utilized for that purpose or not. And what is the basically cost benefit analysis of that particular finance you have gathered for. Next was related to all disciplines, which basically we were discussing about how it is related to different subjects like economics, accountancy, mathematics, and other management areas. The same topic is going to be covered in today's lecture in the later slides. And the last part was decision making. I have stressed most importance on the three important points. Financial management basically talks about three important decisions. First is financing decision, second is investment decision, and third is dividend decision. Today we are going to cover at the end the most important long question, scope of financial management, under which I am going to discuss all these three points in a deeper sense. So we will cover this entire topic in that particular point. After this, you have given your test your knowledge series, and I hope you might have all got these answers correctly. Well, then we started a topic in the last lecture. What is the relationship between the finance and other disciplines? Like how finance is related to economics, with accounting, with mathematics, and other management areas. So how we are using the concepts of these different subjects in financial management, and alternatively, I can also say how the various concepts of financial management are being used in this particular subjects. We had covered the first part, that was relationship of financial management with economics, under which first of all we understood two different type of economic factors, macroeconomic factors and microeconomic factors. We related how the different economics concepts are being used directly or indirectly in the various financial management concepts calculations. So now we are starting with the new part, that is for today. What is the basic relationship, or I could put it as what is the basic difference between financial management and accountancy? So let's see it point wise point. The first point that is written over here is accounting, in which I have written it is a record keeping process. So basically, what is the main purpose of accounting? To record the transactions, each and every transactions that are being incurred or that are occurring on day-to-day basis. The task of accounting is to record those particular transactions. So the main purpose, the main objective of accounting is record keeping. On the other hand, what is the main purpose of FM, that is financial management? It is value maximizing. In finance, my optimum objective, my optimum goal is to see that I manage my funds in such a manner that the overall wealth of my equity shareholders increases. Once again, I am repeating. So the main objective in finance is to increase the wealth of equity shareholders. That is nothing, that is your value maximization. Next is accounting relates with the past data. We always record the transactions that are already incurred. We never record the transaction like what is going to happen in future. So basically, accounting is recording of which transactions? The transactions which are already incurred. Against which, when we are talking about FM, that is financial management, it is dealing with the future data, that is the projections. If I want to start a project, I am estimating. The important word over is estimating. I am estimating how much capital would I require to fund that particular project. In crux, I can say accounting deals with the historic data or the past data, while finance is all about the future data, the future projections. Next is, there is certainty in accountancy. It means the transaction which are already occurred, you are 100% sure that they have already occurred. We are recorded direct transactions. Against which, finance is totally based on the estimation. It is on the projections. So it is filled with uncertainty. We all know future is uncertain. As a result of which, I am planning everything, but I am not 100% sure whether it is going to happen, implemented in the same manner as I have planned or not. So here I can say finance deals with uncertainty. Next point I have written over here is method. You might be aware there are basically two methods of accounting. One is accrual basis. That is basically what we follow at the time of preparation of final accounts. For example, in accrual system, if I have paid salary of 13 months instead of 12 months, then what we record is, we record it as a prepaid salary. Fine. So what I'm focusing about is, I am recording only those transactions which are pertaining to my particular financial year. I'm not entering the transaction, though which I have paid. Fine. There is a cash flow. I am paying salary for 13 months, but I am not showing in my books of accounts. I am debiting salary of 12 months only in my P&L account. Because of the 13 months, what I am doing? I am deducting it from the total salary paid. As a result of which, my outer column of profit and loss account is going to reflect salary of only 12 months. As a result of which, I can say accounting basically follows accrual method of accounting. Against which, there is a method of cash flow, in which what I am doing is, if I am receiving cash, I will record it as an income. If I am actually spending cash, I will record it as an expense. I am not concerned that whether that particular cash flow pertains to my current accounting period or not. I am not at all concerned with that. What I am concerned is only how much cash I am getting in, how much cash I am paying out. That's it. This is known as cash flow method. So we can say over here, accounting is basically done on the basis of accrual method, while financing is being done on the basis of cash flow method. The next point that I have written over here is, accounting helps you to find out the profit. Fine, profit before tax. As a result of which I have written, it provides you the base for tax payment. You all know tax is being calculated on the income which you earn. An income for a business is nothing, it is the profit. basically accounting helps you out to calculate the profit before tax. I have written into the bracket PBT, which stands for profit before tax. So accounting here is helping you out to calculate what is your profit before tax. It is providing you the base on which the tax calculation is supposed to be done, against which in financial years you are going to plan your tax. How can you save your tax? How can you pay lesser tax and earn higher profits? How can you manage your funds so that your tax outflow can be controlled or can be minimized? In crux, what I can say over here in this point is accounting is providing you the base for tax calculation, while financing is all about planning, about the future. So it helps you out in the tax planning. Next point is, and the last one, it evaluates the financial condition by finding out the deviation. See, accounting basically do not take any corrective actions. The task of accounting is record keeping, as we have studied in the first point. So it can help you out to find out the deviation. My accounting data can tell me that I should have earned the profit of 1 lakh rupees, but I have actually earned of 60,000 rupees. That's it. What does it show? It shows the actual figures that have been actually incurred in this particular year. But it is not going to actually control the same thing. It is just evaluating. So accounting lays down main focus on evaluation of financial condition. Against which, if I talk about FM, that is financial management, it controls the financial condition by taking necessary decisions. So the controlling task is not done by accountancy. Accountancy is only doing the evaluation part. Controlling is possible in the financial management portion. I hope I am clear out with the basic differential points between what is accounting and what is financial management. I'm just giving you guys 1 minute, and I would just like to request you all to take a quick view over this entire slide. Well, friends, I hope you are clear with the points which are mentioned over here. So this was all about how the financial management is being related or is differentiating from the accounting. Let's move to the next point. Relation between financial management and mathematics. Just remember your old days, your school days, when mathematics was your core subject. There were many mathematical concepts that we used to study from first standard till 10th standard. I have mentioned few of the mathematical concepts which are basically useful in studying or in the calculation of various financial management concepts. The concepts of mathematics like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, average, that was your mean basically, weighted average that you used to do at the time of finding the goodwill, if you can remember the same. Next is annuity, power and exponent, etc. All these concepts are basically used to calculate different financial concepts. What are the financial concepts that we are using this mathematical concept in our optimum capital structure? I have explained you basically what is capital structure. Capital structure means if I have estimated that I require 1 crores of the total capital to start my project, I have decided 60% would be my own capital, that is my equity share capital, and 40% will be the outside loans, that is my debt capital. My capital structure ratio between debt and equity is going to be 40% and 60%. How to determine the optimum capital structure? The concept of weighted average comes into play in this particular calculation. Next is EPS. You might be aware of this word. It is earning per share. If I want to find how much I am earning per equity share, the definition for it, the formula for the same is profit available for shareholders divided by number of equity shares. For example, I have earned the profit after tax, which is available for equity shareholder, is rupees 10 lakh rupees. and I am having 1 lakh total outstanding equity shares. So I want to know how much I have earned per share. The answer is simple. 10 lakh was your total profit divided by 1 lakh. That is the total number of share. So for one share, I am getting rupees 10. So basically, this is a normal division. That is a concept of mathematics, which we are using to calculate the EPS, that is earning per share. Third concept over here is value of firm. If I want to know what is the actual value of my firm, of my company, fine. The definition, the formula for the same is net income divided by WACC. It stands for weighted average cost of capital. We are going to deal with these concepts in the later chapters, as a result of which I am not going in much detail, but I would just like to let you know that the concept of division is again used in this particular formula. Next is degree of financial and operating leverage. We are having a separate chapter on this particular part where we are going to deal with this. Present value, which I am going to make you learn in this chapter, and capital budgeting tactics, that are long-term decision-making chapters in which there are various methods in which you are going to choose which project is going to be the ideal project to invest. To decide or to calculate this thing, we are again going to use the various fundamental concepts of mathematics. In CRUX, there are n number of financial concepts, the calculation of which is directly based on various mathematical concepts. Here, what I wanted to prove is, it is just as simple as that, various studies, various concepts of mathematics are directly used in the calculation of financial management concepts. I hope you are clear with this particular part. Moving ahead, what is the relationship between financial management and other management areas? Starting with the first part that is written in your slide, production management. You all know, basically production management is going to deal with, it's simple, production, fine. In production, there are many things that we are going to consider. For example, there is a raw material, there are laborers, there are various factory overheads, administrative overheads, selling overheads, fine. Now, all these are basically my expenses. I need to have fund on my hand to meet all these expenses. So financial management, that is finance department, is someone who is going to provide me funds so that I can easily meet all these kind of expenses. So we can set a link between over here that financial management is basically the backbone who is providing or assisting the production department to continue or go ahead with the production by paying for all these expenses like raw materials, laborers and overhead by providing them sufficient fund. This is the basic linkage between financial management and production management. Second comes materials management. If you are having raw materials on your hand, you are supposed, you feel like you want to store that raw material, then you need to incur certain costs. First cost with regards to material is ordering cost. That is, if you are asking, you want to purchase raw materials from the supplier, you are going to place an order. Fine. There are certain transportation expenses which you are supposed to incur in order to get that material from your supplier. Again, there is an expense. Fine. Who is going to pay you this expense? Of course, answer is finance department. Second and the most important word, it is written over here, carrying or the storage cost. Once you have brought all the raw materials to your particular factory or your warehouse, you are going to store that particular raw material. Fine. Now, there are various costs which are incurred with related to storage. For example, rent of your warehouse. You need to appoint a person who is going to take care of your warehouse. You need to appoint a warehouse keeper. You need to pay salary of him. Again, it is an expense. You may take insurance for all the stock that are lying in your warehouse. You need to pay insurance premium for the same. You need to make proper facilities. For example, if you are dealing in food items which are perishable, you need to maintain a proper cold storage system, an additional expenditure. In short, if I want to manage my raw materials, there are various expenditures under the broad head of ordering cost and carrying cost, which are supposed to incur. Again, the funds for the same are being provided by the financial management. Third part is marketing management. The first point I have written over here is marketing management earns income for financial management by sales. See, the main motive of marketing management is customer satisfaction with profitable exchange. What is the role of marketing management is to increase the sales of the company so that revenue can be generated, as a result of which there is a fund inflow. There is an inflow of money, finance, in our own company. As a result of which, what is the task of finance? To distribute the finance into the various departments. For that, financial department needs money. So from where the money is being coming? From the, of course, sales or the revenue. As a result of which, marketing management helped to publicize the products to increase the sales of our products, as a result of which the sales are get converted into the revenue and the funds are being received by the company. Now these funds are being used by the finance management. So I can say finance department ko paisa milta hai, aata kahan se hai? Sales se. Aur sales boost karne mein help kon karta hai? Marketing management. So here marketing management is being the backbone for the financial management in this particular part. In the second point I have written, financial management pays for all the marketing expense. Marketing wala banda kahega that I want to advertise my product, I want to give certain discounts, I want to pay commission to my salesman. Now all these marketing expenses need money, fine. So who is basically going to provide the money? Financial department. As a result of which we can say marketing management and financial management are both interrelated to each other, because existence of one is totally dependent on the existence of the another. And the last part I have written over here is personnel management, which we rightly call sometimes as a human resource management. From recruitment to post-retirement function, it may be recruitment, selection, training, promotion, demotion, transfer, dismissal, post-retirement functions, employee welfare activities. You name anything which is a part of personnel management, each and everything require funds. And from where the fund is going to come? It is going to come from the finance department. And again, for the regular payment of salary and wages, funds are needed, which are also provided by the finance department. In crux, the main purpose of this topic to make you explain was each and every department you take, you name any field, any discipline, financial management is interrelated with each and every topic in one way or the another. I'm just giving you some time and I would just like to request you to go through all these 4 points which are mentioned on this particular slide, post which we are going to start with the new topic. Well, friends, I hope you have gone through all the 4 points. Now, let's start with the next topic, scope of financial management. This is one of your long questions, which is likely to be asked in your examination. Now, what we are going to study is, what all are the activities which are being taken care of by the financial management? What all are the things are included in the study of financial management? So, over here, in this particular slide, I have broadly divided all the activities of financial management into 3 important points. And guys, you very well, you all are aware about these 3 points. First is financing decision, which is basically focusing on the raising of funds. The question that I used to tell was, paisa aayega kahan se? It has been taken care of by this particular decision, that is your financing decision. Second is, once you have got the money, what you need to focus upon is utilizing those funds. That is investing that funds. So the second decision that you are going to take care of is investing decision. And third is dividend. You have got the fund, you have invested that fund in the project. Now you are going to earn. You are going to earn your profit. So basically how you are going to manage your earnings. It is your dividend decision. Kitna retain karna hai aur kitna shareholders mein distribute karna hai. Is being going to be taken care of by this particular decision. There are many activities that we are going to cover in the 3 following slides, but the crux of all these points lies in these 3 main decisions. That is your financing decisions, paisa aayega kahan se, investing decisions, paisa invest kahan pe hoga, and third is dividend decisions, kitna main retain karunga aur kitna shareholders main distribute karunga. Let's start with the first part, that is raising of funds, which is a part of your financing decisions. What all are the activities which are included in this particular topic? First is estimating long-term and short-term capital requirements. For example, I want to start a project. What is the amount of capital that I may require to start that particular project? In our example that I took in the first lecture, the amount I required was rupees 1 crore. 1 crore is nothing. It is the total estimated capital requirement. So the word you need to remember from this first point that I have underlined over here is to estimate your capital requirements. Second is planning for optimum capital structure. Now the word capital structure, I have explained you 2 to 3 times during this course of study. It means how much my own capital is going to be used for the project and how much borrowed capital am I going to use for the project. In short, what is the capital mix? Kitna equity hoga, kitna debt hoga. It is your debt equity ratio. So capital structure basically talks about how much of equity share capital, how much of preference share capital, how much of retained earnings, how much of outside capital in form of loans, debentures, etc. So what you need to do in the second point, you need to plan for the optimum capital structure. Sabse pehle I have decided I require 1 crore rupees. Second, 1 crore mein se 60 lakhs from equity, 40 lakhs from debt. That is nothing, that is determining my capital structure. Third is planning for optimum level of working capital. Now just for your understanding, what is working capital? You might have came across the concept of working capital in accountancy in the subject of ratio analysis. It is nothing, it is the difference between current assets and current liabilities. From financial viewpoint, I can say to run my day-to-day business, I need certain fund. There are day-to-day expenditure that are going to be incurred for which I require a fund. This fund is known as working capital. So what is the amount of working capital I need to have? So I need to decide the optimum level of my working capital. This is again a part of financing decision. Next point is, once you have decided that aapko 1 crore rupees chahiye, 60 lakhs equity se aayenge, 40 lakhs aapke aayenge debt se, aapko kitna working capital chahiye, you also decided the same. Now what you are going to do is negotiations with different sources of funds. Now you have decided that you want to borrow 40 lakhs rupees from outside. Now what you are going to do, you are going to coordinate, you are going to negotiate on the cost of capital. For example, XYZ Bank is providing me the loan of 40 lakhs rupees. He's telling that he's going to charge 9% rate of interest. So what I need to do is, I need to enter into a negotiation. I want to decide a rate in which both of us, that is bank as well as me, are in a win-win situation. Fine. So this is nothing. This is basically identifying the sources of fund, that paisa kahan se aane wala hai, and negotiating with them on the terms of the borrowings. That may be the cost of capital. Like at what rate you are going to borrow? What is the interest that you are going to pay to that particular source of finance? So the fourth point is basically talking about sources of funds. Moving to the next point, it is talking about appointment of underwriters, bankers, brokers for issue of shares or debentures. If you have decided that you want to issue shares or you need to issue debentures, that you need the mediators who are going to take care of this particular process. You need to associate it or do a tie up with the bankers, fine, with whom your registration is supposed to be done. You need to tie up with certain brokers. It may be share brokers, it may be any financial intermediaries who are going to bring funds or who are going to market your issue. The third part is underwriters. What is underwriter basically? The person who takes guarantee if your subscription is not fully done. For example, I have made an issue of 1 crore rupees. I am getting subscription of only 91 lakh rupees. So they are the one who are taking guarantee. Okay, sir, jitna bhi reh jayega, we will purchase that particular part. That is 9 lakhs is going to be purchased by the underwriters. So underwriters are providing me the guarantee that they are going to buy, they are going to purchase the remaining subscription portion. As a result of which, in return of which, I am going to pay them underwriting commission. So this is just a general idea. This is not going to actually be a part of your examination question. But what you need to remember over here is, at this stage, that is in the fifth point, you are going to appoint the important persons who can facilitate in the transaction of the issue of shares and debentures. The last point written over here is, you are going to adopt the proper procedure for raising the funds. It is not like that, aaj mujhe sapna hai ki mujhe equity shares issue karna hai and it is getting issued. Fine. There is a laid down procedure that I need to follow for raising funds from the market. So I need to adopt the proper systematic procedure for raising my funds. In short, mujhe kya chahiye? Paisa lana hai. From where I am going to bring that finance? What all are the activities that I am going to take care of is covered in this particular slide in the name of financing decision. This is the most important part of FM. Trust me, guys, the three slides that we are going to cover now, this is the first one and there will be coming two slides. If you are through with the concepts which are written over here, you are half done with this particular subject. I would just like to request you to go through quickly through the entire topics which are mentioned on this particular slide. Well, I hope you have gone through all the important words that I have underlined on this particular slide. Moving ahead to the second decision, that is using of funds. That is, paisa aa to gaya, ab usko invest kahan pe karna hai. So what all are the points that we are going to take care of in this particular decision? The first is your long-term investment decisions, which is popularly known as capital budgeting decisions. That I am going to decide under which project I am going to invest my funds. Fine, that is your long-term investment decisions. Second is selection of a proper project for investment. I may be having different kind of projects. For example, I can start a textile business in city A. I can start the textile business in city B, which is going to be the ideal city for investment. Again, it is a decision. If I am having two kind of businesses, it may be regarding the production of grey cloth or it can be the production of yarn. In which project I want to invest my funds. Basically, what we are going to do over here is we are going to select the proper project for our investment, which are for definitely going to earn good returns to me. The third point is to complete the project within the time limit. See, you all know, if the finance is being not properly utilized, if I am not using and completing my project in the time limit, definitely the overheads are going to increase and the return that I was expecting would be coming won't be coming unless my project is completed. So it becomes an inevitable part. It becomes necessary for a financial manager to see to it that the project in which he is investing the funds, in which he is parking his funds, should be completed compulsorily within or before the time limit. The major purpose is because how much delay is going to take place in a project, the later would be the returns that you are going to generate from the project. So it is always a wise situation to complete the project on time or before time. Next part is to bring financial coordination between various departments. We have just covered the topic of relation of financial management with other management areas. Like I would talk, if I'm talking about production management, money will be required for raw materials, wages, overheads. If I'm talking about materials management, there will be the expenses with regarding to ordering cost, carrying cost. If I'm talking about marketing, there are marketing expenses like salary to salesman, commission to salesman, discount, advertisements, etc. And lastly, if I'm talking about personnel department, personnel management, there are n number of expenses related to selection, recruitment, training, etc. and whatnot. Fine. So basically, there should be a proper coordination between all the departments so that the fund that I have borrowed or I have generated, I have raised, should be appropriately divided as per the requirement of each department, as a result of which each and every department can function to its best. Fine. So the next point is there should be a proper financial coordination amongst the department. Next is exercising control over utilization of funds. If I have decided I want 1 crore rupees, I have got 1 crore rupees and I have invested 1 crore rupees. The task is not over, friends. There should be a proper control over the utilization of funds. You need to continuously monitor whether the fund is used for the purpose it was supposed to use. Is there any excess spending on any particular item? Is there any less spending on the particular item? Is your fund is remaining idle? All such questions are supposed to be asked by a finance manager at the time of utilization of the funds. And last is management of short-term finance, that is working capital. I have just explained to you guys, you need certain amount for your day-to-day routine expenses as a result of which you need certain working capital on your hand. You need to manage this working capital too, so that you are never in a shortage of regular working capital and you can easily meet your day-to-day business requirements. So this is all about investing decision. Fine. So at the time of utilizing the funds, what all are the points I'm supposed to consider? Just go through the slide quickly and then we'll be moving to the last part of today's lecture. Well, friends, I hope you have gone through the important points, starting with capital budgeting, proper selection of a project, completion of project within the time limit, financial coordination among various departments, exercising control to see that all the funds are being utilized in the manner they were supposed to be used, and lastly, is meeting your day-to-day money requirement, fund requirement in form of managing working capital. Moving to the last slide for today, management of earnings. You raised your fund, for example, mujhe 1 crore rupees ki requirement thi. I have raised that amount. I have invested that amount in my particular project. Now, after investing my amount, my project has started its operation and it has started generating revenue, earnings for me. Now the question comes, dividend decision. How much should I retain with me and how much should I distribute to my shareholders? So what are the points, the considerations that we are going to take care of in this particular decision? We'll see to it. First part is tax planning. Friends, tax is something that is supposed to be effectively planned in order to properly manage your financial flows. So, as a financial manager, you need to take due care of what is a viable option to your business enterprise. If you're retaining the funds with you, whether it is going to help you in tax saving, or if you are going and paying out the fund to your shareholders, it is going to save tax for you. What is going to be the ideal combination is something that you need to plan for well in advance. This is nothing. The tax planning decision by a financial manager comes under this head of dividend decision. Next is allocation of profit between different types of reserves. I may be having reserves with different names. You all might be aware of the same. At the time of preparing reserve and surplus schedule in preparing your vertical balance sheet, you used to name different kind of reserves like general reserve, capital reserve, investment allowance reserves, and whatnot. Fine. So as a business person, I need to properly allocate my profit amongst the different types of reserves based on its purpose so that I can well allocate my fund and see to it that as and when needed, I can get optimum amount of fund from that particular reserve. Next is thinking or taking decisions regarding payment of dividend. If you have taken preference shares, then you need to compulsorily pay the dividend. If you have taken equity shares and if you are earning profit, you should pay dividends. So taking care of your dividends. Interest. If you have borrowed funds from outside, you need to pay interest for the same and the taxes. So the payment of dividend, interest and taxes are also the part of your dividend decision. Payment of installments of term loans. If you have taken any kind of term loan, you need to pay its principal as well as its interest, that is total installment. So you need to manage your funds in such a way that you are having sufficient amount of fund before distribution as dividend to pay your repayments and installments. Next is need for retained earnings for future targets. You might be having a vision of next 5 years, next 10 years, and you might be well aware as a financial manager, what is the amount of fund you require to finance that particular vision. As a result of which, what you are going to do as a financial manager is, whatsoever profit you are earning in the current year, you are starting to keep aside a part of it as a retained earnings in order to meet the financial requirements of your future time period. And last is, there are two important words over here. Retention ratio. Retention ratio is nothing. It is the ratio of reserves that you are thinking that you are going to retain along with you. And the second is dividend payout ratio. It is the ratio that you are thinking you are going to pay out to the shareholders. I'll just explain with a small example. If I have earned 10 rupees as EPS, earning per share, and I'm thinking that what I'm going to do is I'm going to retain 6 rupees with me, that is with the company, and I'm going to pay 4 rupees to my shareholders. So in this particular case, how much I'm retaining out of 10? I'm retaining 6. So 60% is my retention ratio. And how much I'm paying out of 10? I'm paying 4 rupees as dividend. So my dividend payout ratio is going to be 40%. So this is nothing. This is a retention ratio and dividend payout ratio. 60%, 40%. In crux, all these points are supposed to be taken care of in the dividend decision. So when the question comes, students, what is the scope of financial management? You are going to explain in detail these three major decisions. That is your financing decision, investment decisions, and dividend decisions. I hope I was clear with the entire discussion that we have done and covered today. Now to the final part, that is test your knowledge series. The rules remain the same. I'll be providing you 25 to 30 seconds per MCQ. Meanwhile, you need to note the correct answer and keep it along with you. After completion of all the 5 MCQs, we are going to discuss the correct answers. I hope you are all set for the same. Wish you all the best, and your time starts now. Well, I hope, students, you are all set with your answers. So let's check the correct answers. The first question was, which of the following is not the activity of accounting? Please lay stress over here, is not the activity of accounting. So the correct answer is option number C. It deals with future data, because we all know accounting is basically related to past data, the transactions that have already occurred. Finance is something which deals with future data. So here, dealing with future data is not the activity of accounting. So option C is the correct answer. Second question was, estimating capital requirement. Mujhe kitna paisa chahiye in order to fund my project? Is a best decision? It is your first, that is your financing decision. So option A is your correct answer. Working capital management, that is day-to-day ke liye requirements. I want how much amount of capital to pay my regular expenses. So my working capital management is an investing decision. Investing decision basically lays stress on long-term decisions as well as short-term decisions. So the correct answer is option B, investing decisions. Tax planning. If I'm going to retain the money, I'll save more tax. Or if I'm paying the dividend, then I'm going to save more tax. Tax planning is basically a part of DESH decision. Correct answer is option C, dividend decision. Last is determining capital structure. कितना इक्विटी होना चाहिए, कितना डेट होना चाहिए. वेर यू आर डिसाइडिंग दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग इन द फर्स्ट डिसीजन, दैट वॉज आर ऑप्शन ए, फिनेंसिंग डिसीजन इज योर करेक्ट आंसर. आई होप दिस वर इजी क्वेश्चंस व्हिच यू हैव डिस्कस्ड इन द स्कोप ऑफ फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट. होप ऑल ऑफ यू माइट हैव गॉट इट करेक्टली. सो विद दिस आई थैंक यू ऑल फॉर योर पेशेंट लिसनिंग एंड होप टू सी यू सून इन माई नेक्स्ट लेक्चर. थैंक यू फ्रेंड्स.